I'm your maths teacher, so today we'll study from MathWise book 5. Right, so we will solve question number 14 today. The diameter of moon is about 154 times the diameter of Phobos. This is one of the moons on the Mars, right? So the diameter of moon is given 3475 kilometers. Find the diameter of Phobos. Right, so diameter of moon is this. Diameter of Phobos we have to find out. 154 times the diameter of the moon. Phobos ka jo hai, moon ka jo diameter hai, 154 times hai Phobos se. So simply we will divide this and we will find the diameter of Phobos will be 22.56 kilometers. Then question number 15 is there. Nadia collects newspapers and magazines for recycling. After recycling center, she receives this much amount for newspaper and this much amount for magazine. Okay? How much does she receive in all? Total amount. How much she will get? So here Nadia receives 185.75 rupees. Then this is for newspaper. And for magazines selling, she gets 237.45. So we will add them and in total she will get 423.20 rupees. Right? Okay, then. Question number 21. We'll move to 21. These are all very easy questions, so you can practice yourself. If you don't able to solve, you can comment me. I will be happy to help you. Okay. 21 question. Jameel lives 4x5 kilometers from park. Sadiq lives 7x10 kilometers from park. So these are the distances the Sadiq and Jameel lives from park. Who lives closer to the park and by how much? Right. So Jameel lives 4x5 kilometers, Sadiq lives 7x10 kilometers from the park, right? So in decimal fraction we can change this 4x5, we change into decimal fraction, that is 0.8 kilometers. 7 over 10, we change this into 0.7 kilometers. So Jameel lives 0.8 kilometers, Sadiq lives 0.7. So I have drawn this a picture. So but this is park and Jameel is 0.8 kilometers and this Sadiq lives, Jameel is 0.8 and Sadiq is here. Jameel is 0.8 and Sadiq is 0.7. So you have to decide who lives closer. So this is up to you. Okay, then question number 22. Here some mixed fractions are given. So we have to change into mixed fractions. Improper fractions are given, so we have to change this. So 35/9, so simply you divide 3 whole 8/9, that is a mixed fraction. 101/11, simply you divide 9 whole 2/11 is mixed fraction. 63/6, this is improper fraction, so divide 10 whole 1/2 by cancelling this. So 97/8, 12 whole 1/8 by dividing this, right? Then 23. This is mixed fraction is given, we have to change this into improper fractions. 4 whole 2/3, this is a mixed fraction given, so we simply 4 is 12 plus 2 14/3. This is mixed fraction. 10 6 are 60 plus 7 67/10. 33 multiplied 3 99 plus 100/3. 1199 plus 100/3. Right. So question number 26. This is I have not done. Use your protractor to draw the angles. Protractor. You just simply take protractor and draw these angles. Right from the protractor. Then find HCF. So these are the number given. So HCF 12 and 24. Simply you can do it by taking their prime factors, then you take this prime factor. So 12 is the HCF, 24 and 36, take their prime factors, right, and then 12 is the HCF. So question number 27, I have not done this, simply you have to work this write whether the angle formed by the clock hands is right angle, acute angle, or obtuse. So you have to, you know that acute angle is less than 90 degree, right angle is 90 degree angle, and obtuse angle is greater than 90 degree. So you have to decide which one is acute and which one is obtuse. Right? So this is also given. Right? Okay. Then question number 28, find the LCM. Right? So LCM, we have 42 and 56 are given. Right? So LCM by Dwyer method I have taken. So 168 is LCM. Right? Taking prime factors and then you multiply them. Then here 49, 45, 40, 72 is given. Take LCM by Dwyer method and get there LCM. Right? Okay. Then we have question number 29. What is the smallest number that is exactly divisible by 32, 32 16 and 24? Take their LCM by Dwyer method and solve this. So taking LCM by Dwyer method, right? Taking prime factors and multiply them and then you will get the answer. Right? So for 30, I have left this. 31 is there, done 31. What is the maximum number of monkeys that can be fed for 60 bananas and 150 peanuts so that all of them get equal share of bananas and peanuts? So here 60 and 50 are given. We'll take their LCM by Dwyer method and we'll see if 300 monkeys, right, will get the equal type of food. Equal share of food, right? Then question number 22, what is, this is 1 over 3 of 50 salmon is, okay, exercise question number 32, right? So what is 1 over 3 of 50 salmon, 2 over 5 of 125? So simply you have to multiply off means, you put multiplication sign here also. So multiply 10, 3 ones are 3, right? Here 19 times 3 is 50 salmon. So 19 is the answer. Here 2 or 5 multiply 125. So we'll multiply, we see the 5 1 is 5, 5 2 is 10, 2 carry 5 for the 25. So 25 2 is 50 is the answer. So this is all from unit number 1. So hopefully we'll start unit next exercise or next chapter next time. Thank you very much.